5 tips for Cuphead. Cuphead and Mugman have finally made their way to a television near you. These two mischief makers were high on their luck at the local casino when they were made an offer they couldn't refuse. Like good boys and girls know, talking to strangers typically leads to trouble, but Cuphead and Mugman disobeyed their elders and lost a bet with the devil himself. Now these two are on an adventure to pay off their debts. If you've been waiting for the next Contra-like classic, look no further. Here are 5 tips to keep this arcade shooter from getting the best of you. Tip number 1, custom controls. With its level and boss design, Cuphead has the player utilizing every skill the character has, just to survive. Dashing and parrying are crucial, and purchasing the additional power-ups will help you out tremendously. The trick to beating Cuphead is simple. Dodge the fast-paced attacks while dealing damage to your enemies. But this is tougher than it seems. Luckily, Cuphead designers realized that gamers might have their own button preference to help optimize their playstyle. They've given players the option to map the controls however they'd like, so take some time to figure out what feels best for you. If you're using a controller, we recommend using one of the trigger buttons to shoot, so you can hold it down the entire time without having to think about it. Tip number 2, coins and shop. When you get the chance, complete the run and gun levels first. These levels have coins you can collect and use in the shop, which is where you can buy power-ups called shots and charms. Shots represent your attack type, and they're pretty well balanced. For example, spread has great damage with a short range, while lobber does good damage at a medium range. Each shot will also change your X move, aka special moves, and the number you have available to use are represented by the cards at the bottom of the screen. So make sure you're using the right shot before unleashing your desired X move. Charms are balanced too. Some give you more HP but will lower your attack, meaning boss fights will last longer, but you'll be able to make more mistakes. We suggest grabbing the smoke bomb charm first. It makes you invincible while dashing, which is essential for staying alive. Speaking of, tip number 3, dashing. Dashing is a skill that you'll need to master in order to advance in Cuphead. You'll want to map it to a button that isn't controlled by your thumbs, so for controller users, we recommend mapping it to one of the bumpers. Dashing will send you forward in the direction you're currently facing, and while it allows you to dodge, you'll still take damage if there are enemies in your path, which is why we recommended the smoke bomb charm in the previous tip. This will let you dash through enemies to get behind them or dodge attacks that come close. Dashing is also required to get through some obstacles in the run and gun stages. Keep in mind that in these stages, you don't have to kill everything, so dash past them all if you can. It's called run and gun, after all. Tip number 4, parry. Parry is a useful skill, but often forgotten about until it's necessary. Occasionally, enemies and bosses will shoot a pink bullet or item your way. Jump in the air, then click jump again to parry these items. Unless, of course, you're using the pea sugar charm, then it's automatic. Once an item is parried, it will either disappear completely or be useful to you in some way. When parrying, you'll also be sent into another jump, which will help you hit coins previously unreachable, jump gaps, or hop on ledges. If you plan on getting a high grade in any level, you're typically required to perform at least 3 parries throughout the battle or stage, so be sure to practice. Tip number 5, shortcuts. After your umpteenth time fighting a boss, you may need to take a mental break. If you don't have the ability to image search adorable cats on the internet, you can stay in-game and try a shortcut. When you reach a certain point on each island, you'll come across hidden paths that will allow you to access more of the island without needing to beat the boss standing in your way. These shortcuts lead to new bosses and levels. Taking advantage of them will let you cleanse your palate while gaining experience and regaining the will to take on the previous boss. Plus, you'll get an achievement just for taking on one of these paths. Many of us have been waiting for Cuphead's release since 2014, but the wait was worth it. The gorgeous hand-drawn animations and epic soundtrack is reminiscent of the golden age of cartoons, while the run-and-gun game style offers the familiarity and challenge for gamers of every generation. Cuphead has taught us all one very important lesson. Don't deal with the devil.